The other day, I tried to sell my old couches on a website called KSL Classifieds. And that's when I got an interesting text message that said, "Hi from KSL, is your item still available? Can I pay via check? Text me on 530-380. Please certified check only." Now, anytime that you get someone asking if they can pay via check, you ought to be very suspicious. But I've learned over the past year to not judge people so quickly. So I decided to respond, and I said, "Hello, this is Ben from KSL. You said to text you. Is your item still for sale?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Can I pay via check?" And I'm thinking, dude, I wouldn't be texting you if I didn't accept checks. I said, "Where are you from?" He said, "Texas." And I thought, okay, well, I'm in Utah. Can he really not find better furniture in his own state? I mean, they're not that nice of couches. But I said, "When can you pick them up?" And he said, "After the check is cleared. Can I have the information to mail the check to?" And I'm like, geez, calm down, man. And I gave him my P.O. box. "I will get back to you as soon as the check is mailed." So a day goes by and I write him and I say, "When are you gonna send the check?" He says, "Monday." Well, here I am doing business with a guy in Texas and I realize that I don't even know his name. So I said, "What's your name?" "Emmanuel Lucas." "Okay, Emmanuel, nice to meet you." So the next day I say, "Hello, Emmanuel, have you sent the check?" He says, "Yes, and I included the mover fee. After deducting your item fee, you will have the rest of the funds to my mover." So it sounds like he's gonna send me a check for more than what I'm asking, and then I'll use the additional funds to pay his moving team, which is kind of weird. So I write him and I say, "How much is the mover fee?" "$800. "Holy crap." I said, "You're paying someone $800 to move a $300 couch? They will be picking up for me in 6 different locations." Okay, my scam alert is going off like crazy, but I try to keep an open mind. Maybe he's a furniture collector and he's collecting pieces of furniture from around the country. He finally texts me the tracking number for the check. So I check it and I see that the package is in California. I thought he was from Texas. I write him and I say, "I see that it's in San Bernardino. Didn't you say you were in Texas?" He said, "Yes, they didn't update in Texas. I guess they waited till they get to a bigger facility." Now, I'm not an expert in logistics, but it seems pretty senseless to mail a package from Texas to California if it's going to Utah. Is this the reason the Postal Service is always losing so much money? Anyway, it looks like I have about 2 days until the package arrives, and so I say to Emmanuel, "What day will the movers come to pick up the couches?" "The specialist will come pick up for me after they have received the added funds from you. I want you to deposit the check, and when it clears, you can deduct your $300 and have the rest of the funds sent to them, so they can commence pickup for me." It's not until this point that I realize that I may have gotten myself in a little over my head. I've got a mysterious check on its way to me. There's a team of movers that are on their way to my house. And I'm starting to wonder if this Emmanuel guy is who he says he is. And most importantly, am I ever gonna sell those couches?